In this video, I'm going to show you something a little on the technical side, but it's something that you'll want to know when you need it. I'm going to teach you how to manually go into your web hosting control panel and change the password to any of the WordPress user accounts. And you're going to want to do this in those times where you, it's kind of odd. There are instances where you need to change your WordPress your WordPress password, but maybe there's not an email account tied to it, so you can't go the normal route in WordPress to request a password reset. There are times where you're going to need to go straight into the database to be able to change the password, and that's what we're going to learn in this video. So I'm logged in to my WordPress website right here, and if I scroll down to the Users tab, you can see I've got this one user account, and it's called 60 Minute Website Challenge. So this is going to be hypothetical. We don't know the password for this. The email doesn't necessarily come to us. You can see it's actually not a properly formed email. So if I did a password reset request, that wouldn't work either. I would be in a difficult spot. But it's not that hard to change. So what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to log into your web hosting control panel. Now, I use InMotion Hosting. I recommend them. I personally use them. They're a wonderful web hosting company, and this is the control panel for them. I've got a link down below to them, and I also have a wonderful bonus package if you sign up with InMotion Hosting. But if you have different hosting, it's probably going to look the same. This is a standard, what's called cPanel. Now, it might visually look a little different, but these options are all going to still be there. So we want to find the option that says PHP My Admin. Well, let's see if that's exactly what it says. So I know for me, I got to scroll down here. And yeah, it's right here, PHP My Admin. So go ahead and click on PHP My Admin. It's going to open up in a new tab. Let's just give it a moment here. And now this is live, the raw data that we're going to have access to, exact data that WordPress pulls from in order to decide how to show things. And this is where all your WordPress data is stored. So here I am, and it's going to probably look near identical to this. Now, right here where it says show the seven, for me, that's the name tied to my web hosting account. And so for you, it's not going to say that. It's going to say something different. So we've got this information schema. We don't go in there for anything. It's just going to be right here. And I'm going to go ahead and click on the plus, and this is going to reveal all the databases that I have installed on this web hosting account. Now, I have these three databases because I have three different installations of two WordPress and something else I have on here, and they've created these databases. Now, depending on how many WordPress installations you have, you're going to see one entry here for every database you have on this web hosting account. So for most people, it might just be one, and you would be able to click into that. So, but for me, it's not. I've got these three. So I'm going to show you how I would go about finding which one is the database that is for this WordPress installation. I'm going to go ahead and click on the first one, and it's going to show all the, well, actually, I know immediately that this is it. But what's going to show here on the right is it's going to show all the tables in the database. And the table we're looking for is WP_users, and it's right here. Now, for you, depending on which plugins and themes you have installed, there might be a lot more tables than this. But for me, this is what I have, and right here, everyone's going to have the WP users, or it'll say users, because some security plugins will change the front part, the WP underscore, so it's going to be whatever users. But if you don't have a special security plugin, it's going to be WP underscore user. So I'm going to click in that, and it's going to show a list of all my user accounts right here. Now, as you can see, I just have the one, and that this is where I was going with where I was going to say how I would find out which WordPress install it is. I would just look at the user table because I know this WordPress install only has one user, and that's how I would know. So right here is what we need to change, this user password. Now currently you can see it's got all these strange characters. We've got dollar signs, letters. That's not the actual password that it currently is. This is the password, but then it's been encoded, and this is this string of characters. So what we need to do is we need to change this password, but we need to, before, we can't just type it in. We need to encode it first. So what it's called is, this is called an MD5 hash. And what you need to do is go to Google and type MD5 hash generator. Now for me, I've always just gone to this site right here. It's MD5hashgenerator.com. So what you would do is you would type what you want your new password to be here, and then you would click on generate, and then it will give you that strange characters to just paste into the user table. So if I wanted to make it, so say I wanted my new password to be new password, just like that. I would, well, first they have to do this little CAPTCHA thing here. Then I click on generate. Let me click on close, and here is what I need to paste in, this bit right here. So I'm going to put it in my clipboard, then I'm going to come back here, and right where the password is, I'm going to click on it, double click on it, and now it makes it editable. I'm going to highlight it, and I'm going to paste exactly what the MD5 hash generator password site gave me, and then if I click off anywhere out of the area, it just saves to the database. And that's all there is to it, to change the password to a user account directly in the database. And you can change anything you want here. If I wanted to fix this email address, I would just double click on it and put mine like that. And let's go into the front end of the website. You could see the password did change because it booted me out of WordPress. So now I need to go ahead and log in. And then here I am on the user table. You can see the email changed in real time because I just changed it in the back end, and you can see that it is perfectly updated here on the front end. So that's pretty much all there is to going into the database and manually changing a password to any user account. And, you know, it's not, as long as you follow these steps, there's not really much that can go wrong. Just make sure you go and you go to md5hashgenerator.com, generate the new hash code, copy paste it in. You are golden. Well, that's it for today's video. I'd love to hear your thoughts on it in the comment section down below. Please also give me a thumbs up on YouTube. That really helps me out. And if you haven't subscribed yet to the channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button. That also helps me out. Now, I don't want you to ever leave empty-handed, and that's why I've put together a free video course just for my subscribers called The 3 Steps to WordPress Success. Now, if you would like free access to that course, just go ahead and click right here on the right. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.